Won't that be incredible? And, yeah, I know. It's like, amen. And so it's kind of funny because, you know, we're contemplating this in school. God bless them. They've been great people to work with. But they call us and they said, hey, you know, you can't use the driveway anymore for the trailer, for the stuff, because they had too many problems with, not us, but other people knocking the stuff down. And so I'm like, oh, my gosh. Well, boy, that's got to be confirmation right there, you know. And so we were really excited about this. Oh, and get this. This is awesome, okay? We're going to be able to leave all of our stuff at the building.
Yeah!
Awesome. Yeah. All the musicians, all the uppers and downers are going, it's about time. And so there will be a little bit of setup we'll have to do, but not nearly as much. We've got a space that we can leave all our stuff in, our sound equipment. He's going to let us put our snake underneath the slab. It's going to stay there. The board will stay there hooked up. Yes, I knew I could get some hands raised back there. Speakers, we'll be able to stay there. Drums, we can leave set up. Larry, isn't that great? We just roll them off to the side. Yes. It's going to be a great, great thing. So that's the big announcement. December 7th is going to be our first day. Now, we're going to think, if you maybe ask you, oh my gosh, can we afford that? Is that going to be wild? We have done a lot of looking at Lee Summit about what would be the next step after the school, and every time I look, I get discouraged, because it would literally take 100% of our budget to even rent like a storefront place. And I'm just like, wow, that means I would have to, you know, deliver milk or something, and that'd be bad on our sermons, you know what I mean? And I mean, I'm willing to do that for sure. There's nothing wrong with that. But I'm like, boy, that would really stretch us. But what we've done is we've been working with the people over there, and they're going to let us get into the building to rent it for just a little bit more than what we're renting this place right now. And so we're really excited about that. We're signing a one-year lease. It's going to be the same price for that whole year. So if anything happens, we can get out of it. But here's what I want to happen right here. So let me cast a little bit of vision. Is I want us to, in the next 2 months, one of the things that we're going to need to do is we've got to upgrade some of our equipment. We're going to have to buy some dividers, some nice stuff for the back to divide that back kids area into two rooms. And we want to get some stuff that's good, that's durable, that works really well. We're also going to need to do some advertising. You do a relaunch, it's great, but you got to let people know about it. You got to create some buzz. And we certainly did that back when we first started. I mean, we went from 12 to 180 by doing some really good advertising, and it works. We need to do some more of that. And also, one of the things we want to do is we want to put a little bit of money, just put it in the bank for a contingency fund, just to have, so we've got a little bit of margin, a little bit of extra just in case. And so in the next 2 months, what I want us to do is I want us to raise about $30,000 from within our church. Now, that may sound like a lot of money to you, but I guarantee you, by the time you get done with advertising and some of the stuff we need to do, it's gone like that. And so what I'm going to be asking you guys to do is for you to just, those of you that give tithe, you know, God bless you, that money is used for the operation of this church. For those of you that tithe, I'm going to be asking you to prayerfully consider giving over and above that. In some way, some of you can do that to a great degree, some of you can do it to a little degree, but I want you to consider that. For those of you that may not tithe or may be considering it, I would like for you to consider giving a tithe offering. Maybe for the first time for some of you. Not everybody can give the same amount, but everybody can sacrifice in a way. And what we're going to do is we're going to band together, and over the next few months we're going to prepare ourselves in that way and prepare ourselves spiritually, which, by the way, is the most important part of this deal. And that's what we're going to be talking about in the next few weeks. And then we're going to be in the building, have a soft open on December 7th. You know, there'll be people that'll come out just wanting to check out the thing, okay? But it's going to be, the whole month of December, it's going to be kind of more for us, just getting our act together as a family, okay? Getting used to the building, making sure everything works right, that we're doing it the right way. And then mid-January is we want to start doing the advertising, do the mail drops, billboard, if we're able to, yard signs, you guys inviting your friends, and then just have a relaunch date and just pack that place out and just say, God, we're going to throw a long one and we're going to just work our tails off and we're going to allow you to catch the ball and we're going to believe in you to bring a lot of people into your kingdom. and a lot of people into this church that need a church like this. Okay? What do you think? You want to do it? Here's the kicker, and I'm going to end with this right there, and we're going to take communion together. Here's how it'll work. We could raise $30,000, we can get the building, and there could be no difference. The building's not the silver bullet, guys. It's one issue that we think will help us a lot. It will help us with our community for the, hey, that's a stable church that's going to be around a while. That is going to help, for sure. Okay? But it's not the biggest piece of the pie. The biggest piece of the puzzle has to do with the spiritual side of it. And that's what we're going to be talking about for the next few weeks. And I'm going to be asking each of you guys and gals to get yourself maybe in a place with God that maybe you've never been before. Okay? I want to read you some scriptures to describe this. Exodus 24:3 says this. When Moses went and told the people all the Lord's words and laws, they responded with one voice. Everything the Lord has said, we will do. Remember that, one voice. 2 Chronicles 5:13, the trumpeters and the singers joined in unison as with one voice to praise the Lord. Philippians 2:2, then make my joy complete by being like-minded, having the same love, being one in spirit, one in purpose. And then, of course, Acts 2:44, at the very end of that, it says, and the Lord added to their number daily those who were being saved. And the reason why he did is they were in one accord. They were one. There's a common theme there, and it's the word one. Now, the series is called not dream. It's called one dream. Now, that is because God has one dream. But it's also because of this. It's because we need to have one dream. We need to be of one voice. We need to be of one mind. Can you imagine what we could do if we were praying one prayer together? If we had one love, if we showed love to each other and to our city like never before, would that be powerful? Would God honor that? Would he do something? He did it with Ian. He'll do it with others. What if we were in one spirit together? What if we were in one commitment together? I believe if we committed ourselves to that, we would see God do some pretty stinking awesome things. And then we could high-five each other and say, look what God did. I don't know about you, but I like that. That's a dream that God has. And I cannot sit still. I cannot sit still. When I talked to Ian last night, I'm telling you what, I sat there and I think, God, can I just be honest with you? There have been days in the last 3 years that I have woke up in the morning and I've said, God, give me one reason. Give me one good reason why I should keep doing this. I mean, seriously, there have been some days where it's been hard. But then something like that happens. Or I'll hear one of you guys say something about something that God is doing in your life, and I'll go, that's why. That's one good reason right there. And I've just got this hunch that there's a bunch of other good reasons that are walking around out there. Some of them live next door to you. Some of them you work with. Some of them go to school with you. And I want us to have one dream and say, God, let's do this thing. Are you in? Are you with me? Let's do it. You guys get to your feet. Worship team, come on up here. Russ, Christy, you guys come up here, and we're going to take communion together. And here's the deal right here. This worked out perfect.